Get ready to match the stars from Carter Country, Geech Cook, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from What's Happening, Mabel King, from Flying High, Ken Olsen, and Marcia Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Raven.
Would you like to read my tie?
Yes.
What does it say?
Oh, Dum Dora, Dum Donald, Old Man Periwinkle, Mrs. Perkins, Weird Willie, Eula Edna, Unlucky Louie, Big Bertha.
Cut.
I'm through.
Okay. Did you see the sweet lady in the Whiz? She was wonderful. The Whiz. Now, here's the current champ, Mr. Hank Lenhart. Say hello to Hank. Oh, Hank, that's $5,700. How do you feel about that?
Love it.
And have you spent it in your mind yet?
Oh, I think I can.
You can find ways to spend it. Okay, Hank. We'll see how much more money you're going to win for the audience match in a moment or so. Right now, we've got this for you. Okay, here we go with Hank Lenhart. All right, Hank, you've won one game, which got you, you know, went all the way with it, got your $5,600, and then as time expired last time, you won the other game, second game, another 100, you have 5,700, now we'll see how much more you'll win with this audience match. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to do back in blank. And remember how it goes, $500 for matching their most popular, and for the second most popular, $250, and $100 for the third. Now, what do we got here for some help from our ding-a-lings?
Brett.
Back in town.
Back in town.
Marcia.
Back in business.
Back in business.
Has nothing to do with me,
oh,
just
no,
a cat.
Oh, no, of course not. I understand, Ollie.
Bill Daly.
Yeah.
Charles. Charles.
Back in a saddle again.
Okay, Tom Mark. There they are, back in the saddle again, back in business, and back in town. Three that the celebrities gave you. Remember the option, choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Back in the saddle again.
Back in the saddle again is what we want. Let's go over here and find out if we've got it anywhere up there. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number.
What?
Back in the USSR.
In the USSR.
Really?
Yeah.
Do we have Russians?
Could you hum a few bars?
Back in.
No. Can anybody hum it? No.
Yes.
No. It's a song by the Beatles. Can anybody sing it?
That.
Can you sing it? No. Can anybody sing it?
That's a song from the Beatles?
He said, well, now Hank says it's a song that was done by the Beatles. I'm friend. It is true, yeah. Can you sing it, Roger? Roger, it's your big chance to get on camera and all that. Come on, Raj.
Oh.
Come on, Raj. Get out here and sing the song. Okay, Raj.
What happened?
You blew it. You could have made $52 extra in your paycheck this week and all that. Okay, here we go with a $250 response. Back in the saddle again. Congratulations. There you go. You got it there. Now, wait a minute, Duke. Where are you going?
That should have been the $500.
We're a very tough outdoor cowboy type.
Yes, we are.
We're upset. That saddle should be first.
Well, I'm sorry. I apologize about that,
well,
fellas.
Well, we want a horse last. You're weird. Come on. Let's
go. I don't know. What do you think is up under the big one? Hey!
Back in town.
Back in town.
Back in town.
Lulu's back in town. Slide it, Ari.
Oh, you lucky.
Where was that poll taken?
That poll was taken right in this very audience. We had a weird bunch like these out here. Well, you didn't even think of it there.
It was taken in the USA.
All right, Hank, you got 250 additional. That means the least you play for is $2,500, 10 times that amount. But you can play for $5,000 or double that amount if you get a lucky spin on the star wheel. Go, and good luck to you. Let's hope he gets a double. Here we go. Yeah. Nope. Stop right there, Ken.
Yes, well,
okay. Well, Hank, you've been playing with Ken Olson for $2,500. Good luck to you. Face me, if you would, please. And this is it. Blank Arts. A-R-T-S. Blank Arts.
Oh, I remember how it
right.
Works. It's wonderful.
Okay, Blank Arts. If you give us the answer that he's written, put on the card there, you got $2,500.
Martial Arts.
Martial arts.
Martial arts.
All right. A rather esoteric answer, isn't it, Hank? It is an esoteric answer. What do you say there, Ken?
I put fine arts.
Fine arts. Did you think of fine arts?
No.
Yeah. I think fine probably be a little more popular than martial arts. But anyway, you picked up an additional $250 plus $100 for the game. You got $5,950 and a new player. Here is Lydia Gallagher. How nice to have you with us.
Thank you very much.
You have, doesn't she have beautiful occhi d'Arnia? Yeah.
Let me see, what is that?
That's dark eyes. She has beautiful eyes.
Thank you very much.
We're from the same
place. Where are you from, Lydia?
I'm from Anaheim, California.
She's from Anaheim, California. What else?
Well, I'm married to my husband, Kent.
You're married to your husband? She's married to her husband.
Talk about kinky.
And I'll fight any man in this bar who says she isn't.
I have a son, Jake, who's 14 months.
Right.
I work as an
right.
Accounts.
So far, everything you've said is correct there. Haven't made a mistake yet, Lydia.
No, I work as an accounts receivable clerk, and I'm happy to be here.
She works as an accounts receivable clerk. Okay, it's a nice straight line, isn't it?
Yes.
I'm an accounts receivable. All right, Lydia, we'll start by asking you to make a decision here about A or B.
I think I'll take A.
A. A. Is your husband out there?
Yes, he is.
Is he the one who just said you should have taken B?
I don't know.
Let's see how you do with it. Frugal Phyllis finds a use for everything. Last year, she took her old steel wool and knitted a blank.
It's going to make sense.
I guess we're ready for you, Lydia. Frugal Phyllis finds a use for everything. Last year, she took her old steel wool and knitted a blank.
Sweater.
A sweater. All right. Yeah, might be a little difficult to wear, something like that.
You talk about difficult to wear.
A chastity belt.
Yeah. It was comfortable, though.
Yeah. Well, that's what you do with metal. That's made out of metal, and steel wool is metal, after all, isn't it?
Did anybody say anything about Frugal Phyllis being frigid?
I didn't.
I don't get that at all.
Well,
it doesn't matter, frugal or frigid, in the belt.
No, to you it doesn't. To Phyllis, it's very important. I said a nice blanket for her bed.
A nice blanket for her bed. What did she knit
there? My grandpappy was back in the saddle again.
Yeah.
Don't hit it, hurts when you do. We found four of those old spare chastity belts in an old covered wagon.
I didn't know they wore them in those days. Hello, Mabel, darling.
Hello, darling.
Frugal Phyllis took a steel wool knitted a...
sweater, so she can scratch home.
Sweater!
I wonder, Lydia.
Okay.
Oh, Gene,
yes.
Years from now, when you think of this rotten answer, please be
kind.
I said she knitted a stove.
Knitted a whole stove. Stacking
very talented
all, eh?
Lady.
Yes.
Busy fingers.
You remind me a little bit of Richard Deacon.
Yes, I am his lost younger brother. Would you believe that?
That's right. I do believe that. Indeed, I do. Hello, Marcia, darling.
Hello, Gene.
It is Gene, isn't it?
Yes, it is Gene.
Don't be so hard on yourself. That wasn't a rotten answer.
You're so sweet for an older woman.
She had a lot of steel wool. She knitted an entire kitchen.
Oh.
I like it, Marcia.
That is a difficult one. So Lydia has one. Hank, you stand by for yours. Now you stand by for this, if you please. All right, here we go. Hank, this is yours. Hey, did you hear that Big Bird is producing a soap opera?
Yeah, it's called As the Blank Turns.
See?
All right, Hank. Did you hear that Big Bird is producing a soap opera? It's called As the Blank Turns.
I have to say Birdcage.
Oh, no. That's
now, Hank.
That's very good. Very good.
As the Birdcage turns.
That's the Bird's world. It's a very moving answer.
I think it stinks.
The whole world is that cage.
All right.
The world is a cage.
It's very poetical.
It is.
I think.
Yes. You know what he's setting us up for? He's probably got a worse answer than Hank's. Hello, Geech.
Well, I thought it would have been a feather in his cap. If he'd put for egg. As the egg turns.
Soap opera is called As the Egg Turns. Okay, that's a bird's answer. What do you say?
Well, the earth is round, right? And the world is round and all of that.
Almost. It's an oblate spheroid, if you want to be technical about it. But we'll say the earth is round.
Say it fast, five times.
Oblate spheroid, oblate spheroid. Go.
You only said it twice. Egg.
Egg. Yeah. Yeah.
Whenever he wears blue, he gets into that strange mood. I wish I had a real one right now.
Oh, you do.
You have one. You do. You just laid one.
Okay, we got a lot of eggs, but we have no bird cages there. What do you got, Mabel?
I have an egg.
Another egg there? Okay.
Make that two or
another
four.
Another egg there? Show us your egg.
I beg your pardon.
Yes.
How rude. I just love these philosophical questions, man, you know? As the beak turns.
As the beak turns. You know, no one came up with the definitive answer.
We thought that was,
what was
up
it?
Here.
What is?
As the worm turns.
I'm so ashamed.
As the worm turns.
Of course, you're not under pressure, you know.
Yes.
You're under medical care.
No, As the Stomach Turns was Carol Burnett's takeoff on it, wasn't it? Yes. Okay. Now, here we go. Where are we? 1-0, and we go to round two. Lydia, A or B?
A, please.
All right. President Carter said...
I remember him.
You do Carter?
No. Oh. I just say I remember
you do
him.
Carter. You do Carter. Yeah, read it as read President it? Carter would say.
Oh, I don't do the imitations. I do Carter Country. All right, this is...
He's also in the White House. Let's see him. Let's see you try and do President Carter. That's our president. You know, his name's Carter, too.
Maybe here, just I'll smile. Will you hit me?
No.
President hit me with the big words.
President Carter said,
I'm having a hard time in Washington. I even have to get congressional approval when I want to.
Blank.
Stinks. The worst imitation of President Carter I've ever heard in my entire life, ever.
Richard Paul does a pretty good job, doesn't he? Yes.
I didn't even understand it. You talk so funny.
I'm having a hard time in Washington. I even have to get congressional approval when I want to blank.
Oh.
I would leave it at that because you matched in the first round, you see. President Carter said, I'm having a hard time in Washington. I even have to get congressional approval when I want to blank.
Use the restroom.
Use the restroom. Okay. Now, what was so difficult about that?
That was easy. I was going to say tinkle.
Okay. There's one. Right. You?
He is cute.
He is cute.
He's just cute. We have a lot of friends in common. I say go to the bathroom.
Okay. Two. Three all together.
Freddie and Gene Boccolodio. That's his last name, Boccolodio.
Right.
Make love to Rosalind.
Make love to Rosalind. Okay, we're up to you there, Ken, baby.
Oh,
what do you
I
say?
I'm so embarrassed.
What?
I say...
Eat peanuts.
Eat peanuts.
Okay. She stays at three there.
Sounds good to me.
It does?
I always hate these euphemisms. They're so coy.
Yeah.
But I got into a lot of trouble once, if you'll remember.
Yes, I know, yes.
Tinkle.
Oh, of course. That's four for her. Here, round two question will be long, right after we do a little business with America. Okay, Johnny O. Now, the score is 4-0, Hank. Means you have to have 4 to tie, 5 to win. Here we go. Everyone plays. Dumb Dora is really dumb.
How dumb is she?
She tried rubbing two fires together to make a blink.
So Paul Lynde, Rex Reed, and I were not in the New York Times.
Right. Dumb Dora is really dumb, Hank. She tried rubbing two fires together to make a blank.
A stick.
A stick.
Yay!
You get the idea in that one, Geach?
You betcha. I've tried that, but it don't work. But you can get a stick. Sometime.
Okay. Rub two fires together. What you got there, honey?
Watch it, baby. This is a stick up.
Oh, all right. Score is now 4-2. You need two more to tie.
When you're not back in that saddle again, you know where you are?
Where?
You're by your beautiful campfire. A stick.
A stick. That's three. Okay, cowboy. Mabel?
Another stick.
4-4. One more and you win the game, Hank. Show us your stick, Ken.
Wow.
Ding, 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 ding. There it is. What do you got, Mike? A stick. That's six all the way.
It's a pleasure to meet you. We'll send some gifts your way. All kinds of wonderful things that you'll use for many years to come. Lydia Gallagher,
ladies
and
gentlemen.
Thank you very
much.
There she goes. Okay, Hank, you're rolling along here now.
You're getting into the big bucks. You got $6,050. Let's see how you do with this one. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank piece. Remember, 500 for matching the most popular, 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third. And three of our six dingbats will help.
Brett.
What I wish Charles would let me do. Die in peace.
Die in peace?
Die in peace.
Marcia.
War and peace.
War and peace. Geach.
Charles.
Oh, Charles. Oh. I thought you were trying to pronounce Geach's name there. What do you say?
That's a good one.
World peace.
World peace. So you have world peace, war and peace, and die in peace. Those are the three they've given you. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
War and peace.
War and peace. Okay. Let's find out if war and peace is up there, and if so, where may we see the $100 number? The $100 number says Dove of Peace. Now, let's go up the ladder and look at the next one, please. World Peace. Well, War and Peace looks like a good possibility to be right up there on top. Slide the big one. Yes, sirree. Yeah, boy, Hank, you're okay. Again, I point out, the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. But get to that wheel and give it a spin. See if you double your money now. Let's root for Hank and double that money. Okay. Yeah, I think it's going to do it. Just swing past it.
Almost.
That's a well-oiled wheel, isn't it? All right, Ken, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Now, you do this again. You've done it before. Let's see how it works this time. Good luck to your hand. Solid gold blank. Solid gold blank. Hank, if you give us the answer that Ken Olson has written on the card, we give you $5,000. What do you say to that? Solid gold?
Cadillac.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a famous Broadway play. I guess they made a movie out of it, too, and you're in show business, Ken. It would be reasonable for this fellow to expect for you to say that. If not, he is going to come over and beat you about the head and shoulders with a large stick.
I'll be leaving now. Good night.
Ding, 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 ding. Now you have $11,550.
Congratulations to Hank Leonard. Now a message for America.
We have 10 seconds. What great words of wisdom would you like to impart to our vast audience?
I would like to say that by the end of the week, we're going to have a contest, and we're going to know what his name is, where it comes from, how to pronounce it, all of that.
He ain't telling nothing. That's old Geach. He'll be here next time with all of us on Match Game 78. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.